Hi.
You know you're my worst enemy, right?
Everywhere I'm looking now. Okay, but we have something for you. So today you're gonna be making a sandwich.
I've never made a sandwich in my life.
Okay, but there's a twist.
It's just a sandwich, what?
Oh, what twist? I don't like twists.
You'll find out in the kitchen.
Okay. Let's go.
What kind of sandwich? Oh, cool. Oh, no. You shouldn't live your life based on luck.
1 eternity later.
This is the one. If I get fruits, I will kick this paper. I went into the door. Last try.
What?
If it's fruits, I'll take it. Okay, lor. Guys, this is not funny. Peanut butter it is. Okay. Let's get cooking. Oh my god, ice cream. Last chance. I give $20. No. Maverick, $20. I want fruits back. Well, I plan to make many things, but I couldn't. So I'm just gonna attempt to make fried ice cream. I don't know if this is gonna work, but let's just deal with it. Here are the ingredients that I'm gonna use. Flour, egg, panko, some salt, bread, and of course the ice cream. Cross fingers with me while you watch this video because I don't know if this is gonna work. First, I'm gonna flatten the bread to make sure that the air pockets are gone so that it can keep more ice cream in the center. So here are 3 plates. I'm gonna put flour, eggs, and the panko breadcrumbs here. Oh, got potato chips. Do we have potato chips? Oh my gosh, I don't use panko, I use potato chips. I'm going in this with the image that it's gonna be a success, but I don't know if it will. Okay, can we do that? I don't think this will go well with mint ice cream. I'll set all this aside and I will prepare the ice cream sandwich first. Okay? Is it combining? Oh no! She got a shock.
So you put the ice cream at that?
Like what? Oh!
What are you?
An idiot sandwich.
How much should I cut? Quarters, huh? The size is just nice. Then I'm gonna pinch the sides. Okay. This one. You know what? I'm just gonna put it in the freezer immediately. Now, let me prepare the station. I'm scared. It's okay. Success comes when you're out of the comfort zone. So I guess it'll be successful because I'm feeling super out of my comfort zone now. Okay. If you see bubbles around whatever you just dropped in, right, it means it's ready. Ah! Wait. Got plate or something to like. Okay, I'm gonna dredge it in the flour first. Oh my gosh! Quick! Get coated, damn it! It's not getting coated. I tell you, the ice cream melted already. It's gonna go in. Are y'all ready? Ah!
You just dumped it in.
Ooh! Okay. I think Henry. And ta-da! Ice cream sandwich! Wow, 10 times better.
The twist is...
Mm-hmm. Oh no! Ha! Oh my god, if I get prawn or chicken, I think I might have a heart attack. Okay, here we go. No. Oh, bismillah. Oh god. Just don't start here, so start here. Confirm get avocado. Let's start here, peanut butter. Strategy. Oh my god! Blessed be is to the god that has served me well. Oh, I've got fruits! Yay! And I'm glad because I like a little bit of a sweet sandwich. I do like savory sandwiches, but I think when it comes to savory things, I'm not the best. But fruits, okay, they are not icky. Here we go! So my ingredients are bread, of course. We've got a couple of fruits. We've got bananas, strawberries. We've got some honey and peanut butter, which is always a good combination. And I'm going to attempt to whip some cream. So I've got, I guess, cream and sugar. Good luck to me. You know what? At home, even when I bake, right, I always hand whisk. I never use one of these electric whisk thing because I'm too scared. I'm scared everything will fly everywhere, you know? Now, what I assume I do is I pour the cream inside the bowl. I mean, like, is there anywhere else it should go in my mouth?
Just gurgle it.
Don't say these kind of things. I might actually do it. I never knew it was so thick in consistency, leh. Okay, how much sugar? I would assume 1:1. Yes? No? Anybody want to give me a clue? No? No? Nobody wants to give me a clue, so I would say 1:1. Oh my god, I'm scared. I'm tired. Do people make their own? Why don't you just buy those from the can? Someone say I have to agitate it. Hey, faster! You're too slow! You are a bad cream. Okay, okay, let's cut some fruits then. Okay, strawberries. I must get one of these knives. They're very sharp. You know, not for cutting fruits, but for cutting people out of your life. Guys, this is like the first time I don't feel like a failure. Eh. Now, all you need to do is build the sandwich, guys. Where's the toaster? Do you have a toaster? So we're not gonna toast the bread? You guys are really pushing me. I guess into the oven it goes. Do I want a little bit of butter on that toast? It will. Off in the oven it goes.
Moments later.
Okay, I'm scared. I will stop it. It's been a minute, guys. I never toast my bread that long, you know? Oh, wow. It's still freezing cold. Back in you go.
More moments later.
Okay, like, can. All right, first step. My preference generally is for crunchy. But you know, some people buy you creamy. You just make do with whatever you have, lah. Not to you, for future shows.
Okay, so there will be future shows?
Oh, shit. Oh, my. And now it's as easy as putting the fruits on. I'm gonna make it in a colorful moment. Okay, yes. Ta-da!
Oh! 1, 2, I don't see. Chicken, ah. Do I have time to write down my recipe?
Two very boring minutes later.
Okay, I'm gonna make what I usually make at home. I'm gonna make an oyakodon. But instead of don, I'm gonna use pan. So ingredients we need are eggs, onions, garlic and ginger. We've got our very classic sake and mirin and light soya sauce. I'm imagining the bread to be a bowl and then the oyakodon and then covered by another bowl. So you can just like have it in a circular, rounded, globe shape kind of thing. And hopefully it seals lah. That's the dream. Okay, let's season our meat first. Gonna cut up the chicken in the true blue oyakodon style. Okay, just gonna cut it into very generous chunks. Chicken, done. Just gonna season our chicken now. Our soya sauce, a bit of ginger powder, a bit of garlic powder, salt and pepper. Mix it up, mix it up. And we're gonna lay it to rest. All right, gotta chop an onion. Why am I tearing? It's not supposed to tear. Whole onion done. We're gonna crack our eggs in. Let's start cooking for real now. Really, really very simple ingredients. I'm just gonna heat the pan. Turn it on high. Yeah, we're just gonna fry up some onions, get the sweetness out. Yeah, the aim of what am I doing now is to caramelize it a little so it adds the sweetness into the entire dish. We don't add oil into the onions now because we don't fry it up yet. We are just trying to dry it as much as possible in order to caramelize it. So what we are doing now is to just get the moisture out. Once you're happy with the onions, you can take it out right now. We are taking the onions out because we are going to cook the chicken next and we don't want the onions to be overcooked or even burned. Okay, heat on high, oil in, spread the chicken out. What we want is a very nice brown crust on the outside. Okay, when you see it starts to get whitened by the side so you can flip it around. You see the browning that right at the bottom of the pan? You want to like deglaze the pan in a way or two. So I'm just going to use a bit of sake. Just add a bit of sweetness to the exterior of the chicken while deglazing the pan. Now I'm gonna add a bit of mirin. And now see you have a very nice kind of sauce right at the bottom already. And you wanna lower the heat and then add your egg in. Bring every bit of chicken to the center so every bit of it is coated. As it cooks on low heat, right? What I'm gonna do next is to add the onions in. And then as all the components are cooking, I am gonna dump in what I would dub my secret weapon. It's just a bit of potato starch with hot water. And what this gives is a very nice sauce slash gravy. And then when you're happy with it, turn the heat off. This would be good on rice. This would be good on noodles. Today, it just happens to be we are gonna do this with bread. Might need a bit more salt. Reason why I think that it needs a bit more salt is because of how sweet the onions are. I'm a bit sad that it's not flowy, so what I'm gonna do now, I'm just gonna make more sauce with a bit more egg. Yes! Look at these! Look at how it glistens in the light. Okay, time to shape my bread into globes and then find a way to let it stay, which is gonna be impossible. Yeah, like two curves. All I'm thinking of is to get my glass bowls and then mold the bread according to the glass bowls. This is impossible. I'm just gonna roll this up. I'm just gonna fold it in half. Say something,
I'm giving up on you. That's a dream.
Well, we're the best standard one. We'll put all in here, we'll cut it out. I'm just gonna stack these up. Then you shape this to the size of the cutter also. When it comes to pastry, I cannot there. Just me cook then we just... Wait, math. Oh yeah! Should I have toasted the bread first? Just quick. Okay, let me try. Okay, I'm just gonna flip it now, very gently. There you go!
Oh my god! This is a... Oh my god! That means I'm left with peanut butter, avocado and prawn. All of which I never really worked with before.
Even peanut butter?
No, yeah. Okay lah, you try? 1, 2, 3. Avocado! Oh, die lah, I don't want to open avocado. Okay, can I start lah? This is what I plan to make. Whether it comes out the same way, it's a different thing. This is a plan, okay? Plan, I'm just gonna make an avocado toast or like avocado bread with a side of scrambled eggs. Then this prawn is like, if it looks very empty and I want to go for a hearty meal, I just add some prawns in. Got cheese, sorry. Garlic is my life. So everything I also need is garlic. Chili pepper, which is something like paprika. Or like, I was thinking, oh, maybe this will work too. Oregano, right? On the top of everything, then I just add a bit of. And then pepper also. I'll tell you what, I want to overcome my biggest hurdle first, which is the avocado. Okay, here goes nothing. Okay, then you must like cut around the edge. Then you must twist. Then you must do this. Hey, wait. I'm scared. Hey, shit, no use ah. Oh, twist, as in twist. Like that.
Oh my god.
Why cannot one? Okay. Oh my god. Hey, this is my first time deshelling an avocado. Eh? How ah?
I'm doing great.
No, it's too slippery. How? Hey, wait, how people do it ah? Oh, it's a fork. Yeah, okay, sorry. I mean like ugly, am I right? Okay. Why it tastes so lemony? Okay, I'm taking the salt, some pepper. Okay, some garlic granules. So we did the avocado part already. What's next is the eggs. I think you put inside, then let it boil for 7 minutes. Okay, I'm gonna put one for 7 minutes and one for 8 minutes and we'll see, okay? Okay, you can start now.
Much later.
Hey, aya. To be honest right, I don't know what the hell is this eh. Okay, I think I just don't want my sandwich to be like so soft, you know? Cause like if it's soft right, then it will, whatever moisture on top, it will just soak it up. Okay, for the sake of it right, I'm just gonna put some like garlic, okay? I'm gonna turn it around. nothing happened. Okay. Cheese. This is gonna be a cheesy toast, suddenly I feel that. Oh my god, it smells good. This is just for visual, so this one just need the char. Did they all make edible sandwiches?
What did he say?
I'ma spread this. Goodness, I got people use one to make an avocado toast one. Ayah, this is supposed to look a lot nicer lah, okay guys. But never mind lah, huh? Then right. Okay, I just add a few lah, huh? For like variety purposes. And then on top right, got some cheese. So we'll just end it with some, whatever this is. Okay lah, some oregano.
Tastes a bit savory. The sweetness takes a whole lot of backseat.
How's it?
I think like we should have stopped with the panko because then it can complement with the sweetness of the ice cream more than the chips.
This combination
can go well if it's not mint chocolate chip ice cream, but chocolate not the mint.
So how well do you think Kara?
I think she did very well, considering that it was ice cream, which is one of the harder ingredients on the spin the wheel.
Good job. Very good job on how fast you came in fast, but how well you thought of a game plan.
She's biased against me because I say the pantry is not well stocked. She just want to fight me.
I'm just a small little ingredient.
You're able, we'll all have one big happy family. Woo!
Eh? Wow! Why so I put inside, right? The sandwich. Okay, lah, can I put a bit? I put a bit. Honestly, what could go wrong? It's literally ingredients that you don't have to cook. You just put it together.
It is nice. You should have toasted it a bit more.
If we had a toaster...
So how do you think 40 people?
I think, like he said, the flavours really complement each other. And I think what's missing is just that crunch from the bread. But other than that, it's great.
Like he said, what could have gone wrong?
But with exactly.
Cream, what's a good touch?
You're the one I finished, you know? No?
Basically, the way I cook oyakodon, it tastes exactly like the way that I cook it at home. You can actually use dashi powder or wasabi powder to coat the exterior of the bread and then you go and toast it. So you have that dashi, that seafoody taste. That's like probably one thing I'll do if I were to do this again.
Okay, the patty disappeared. I mean the bread.
Somebody don't know how to eat a burger.
It's supposed to be a sandwich. I mean it's good. Maybe lesser filling so I could actually taste this bread. But it's good.
The highlight is the ingredient, okay, not the bread.
But other than that, it's nice. Good job.
Thank you.
Okay lah, I was afraid that there was not going to be any flavour. But then, not bad actually.
Oh, spicy.
Really?
It's not bad. The mix of the spices around very nice. But I think maybe you could have chopped the prawn. And then like every bite got prawn.
Wow.
How do you think you did?
I think overall it's a job well done because there's like so many layers to this sandwich. You know, there's the avocado, the egg, the cheese, the different spice. I think it all comes together very well to like create this hearty meal.
Would you make it at home?
Yeah.
That's a no.
Yeah. Thank you for watching this episode of How You Cook It. If you like this video, you can watch all the other videos over there. And you can also like, share and subscribe. You can also let us know in the comments down below what else you would like us to cook.